Jesus love. Almighty God, look down upon this child and heal him.
Well, how long ago did he leave?
About 15 minutes ago.
And you won't tell me where he went. Look, this is a blind date. I'm already running late as it is. And when I get here, my date's already gone. And he left before I was even supposed to show. And you're not going to tell me what was so important that he just did.
You want to be normal.
No, I'm sorry.
Don't you tell me you're sorry when you're not. And you know the Lord is watching us. You know we're being tested.
He's not standing you up.
He'll be here soon?
He should be.
This is weird, but I'll wait for a minute. Well, you know what?
Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not on your own understanding. Whoever does not love does not know God. Because God is
to bring you this special report. A patient described as extremely dangerous may have escaped from the Madisonville Psychiatric Hospital 2 days ago, according to an anonymous tip. Hospital officials have released no information, and WMAD is still trying to confirm details. So far, we have had no luck reaching Dr. Franklin Grimm, the director of the hospital, for comment. Our experts recommend that if you see or have seen anybody betraying, contact your local authorities immediately. Please keep your radios tuned to WMAD for the latest updates. To repeat, a patient described as extremely dangerous has reportedly escaped from the Madisonville Psychiatric Hospital, though that information has not yet been confirmed.
I don't have any time. I've got to go.
I know that's what you said.
No, don't even start. I did the head of security call.
You mean ski mask?
Yes, ski mask.
Well, what did you call him when you talked to him?
Ski mask. Did he call?
He's on vacation this week, isn't he?
Yes, I know he's on vacation, but did he call?
No.
Good, let me know if he does.
I can't believe it. Me either.
if he's here today.
What is it?
If anybody sees me, I'll never get out of here. Dr. Grimm.
Dr. Clark. I need to talk to you.
I'm on my way out.
You can't leave yet.
No. We need to talk. I'm on my way out. We'll talk tomorrow.
Tomorrow will be too late.
Yeah, the situation is such.
You're supposed to be at Dawson Springs, aren't you?
My talents are being wasted in Dawson Springs.
Tomorrow, Doctor, tomorrow. We'll talk about it tomorrow, okay?
Dr. Grimm, talking.
Here. We'll talk about it tomorrow. Now, excuse me. You've got to hear my complaints sooner or later.
Tomorrow!
I'm actually
about 2 minutes late. You must be Melissa. We will return the Maniac on the Loose after this very quick message. Thank you so much for watching our movie Maniac on the Loose here on YouTube.
So is Alex home?
He had to go out.
Because I'm actually running really late and he said he'd be here all ready to go.
He should be back soon.
So where'd he go?
Not my place to stay.
Come on. Well, how long ago did he leave?
About 15 minutes ago.
Look, this is a blind date. I'm already running late as it is. And when I get here, my date's already gone. And he left before I was even supposed to show. And you're not going to tell me what was so important that he just stand me up.
He's not standing you up.
He'll be here soon?
He should be.
This is weird, but I'll wait for a minute. Well, you know I'm Melissa, but I don't know your name. So what's your name? What should I call you?
Those are two different questions.
Huh?
You asked me what my name was, and then you asked me what you should call me. Those are two different questions. I'll answer the second one. You can call me Max.
Max?
Yeah, that'll work.
Okay, Max. Okay, this is just too weird. I'm leaving.
No. Don't go. Don't go. He'll be back.
Well, then tell me where he went.
To the store.
For what? Look, you better tell me what he went to the store for, or you better get out of my way so I can leave. Okay, let me put it this way. If you don't get out of my way, I'm going to take my knees and rain your balls up through your skull.
Deodorant.
What?
He was getting ready for your date, and he realized he was out. He ran to the store to get some deodorant.
Deodorant?
Deodorant. So if you want to leave, go right ahead. If you want to stay and wait for him, he shouldn't be much longer. It's your choice.
I'll give him another minute.
Okay. Where are my manners? Can I get you anything while you wait?
I'll take something cold if you'll join me.
water. Go ahead, drink up.
Is there a working fireplace?
Other than the fact that it doesn't have a damper.
Damper?
The thing that you open when you're burning a fire so the smoke goes out the chimney. And you close it when you're not burning so you don't lose any heat. It also keeps animals out. Birds and such.
Well, I guess I don't know much about fireplaces. They're pretty, though.
I like the flames. They remind me of a bunch of tongues licking at the wood.
So, do you live here with Alex?
No. How's that water?
Good. How's yours?
So how'd you meet Alex?
On the internet.
On the internet? You have to be careful with that kind of stuff. There's a lot of nuts out there over those computers.
I'm not worried. Alex seems like a perfect gentleman.
Let me get this straight. You meet some guy over the computer, and then you come to his house? And you said this was a blind date, so you don't even know what he looks like.
That's right.
Not so smart, if you ask me.
For our first in-person meeting, we decided to meet for coffee, in public, in the morning. Wouldn't you say that's pretty safe? Only Alex said his car was in the shop, so he gave me his address, had me to drive by and honk, and he said he'd be right out. Sounded pretty safe to me. Are you sure you're not Alex?
What?
Well, you wouldn't be just pretending to not be Alex because maybe I wasn't what you were expecting.
No, I wouldn't.
If you want to call this whole thing off, that's fine. Just tell me and I'll leave. But don't leave me alone and don't play games.
I said I'm not Alex.
Okay. Have you known Alex long?
I'm helping him do some work around the place.
Oh, is that what you do for a living? A handyman, I mean?
No!
Well, what do you do?
I'm over at the Madisonville Psychiatric Hospital.
The insane asylum?
It's a facility for the mentally disturbed.
Well, but you know all about the escape, then.
The escape?
Yeah, I was on the radio today, a couple days ago, where their patients escaped. They say he's really dangerous. Well, but you've probably heard about it.
What, you think I didn't hear about it?
Well, what happened?
I don't know!
Sorry, I just stopped it. Well, now, you know what? It's really scary, but I think I saw him.
Who?
The escaped lunatic. I think I saw him this morning on my way here. He was standing outside my car just staring at me. Ugh, it gives me the creep just thinking about it.
It wasn't him.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do you know?
You see, you report this shit to the media and suddenly everywhere people turn, they see a maniac on the loose. So what do you think, this guy's just gonna walk around in broad daylight and show everyone how crazy he is? He's too smart for it.
So, do you know who it is?
What? No! Look, what the hell's with all the questions here? I wasn't there when it happened, okay? I don't know anything about it. What, am I supposed to have all the answers? Am I? Am I?
We will return to Maniac on the Loose after these messages.
Now return to Maniac on the Loose.
Are you okay in there? Matt! You didn't touch your water, should I bring it in? like your name? What should I call you?
Those are two different questions.
Huh?
You asked me what my name was, and then you asked me what you should call me. Those are two different questions. I'll answer the second one. You can call me Max.
Max?
Yeah, that'll work.
Okay, Max. Okay, this is just too weird. I'm leaving.
No. Don't go. Don't go. He'll be back.
Well, then tell me where he went.
To the store.
For what? Look, you better tell me what he went to the store for, or you better get out of my way so I can leave. Okay, let me put it this way. If you don't get out of my way, I'm going to take my knees and rain your balls up through your skull.
Deodorant.
What?
He was getting ready for your date, and he realized he was out. He ran to the store to get some deodorant.
Deodorant.
So if you want to leave, go right ahead. If you want to stay and wait for him, he shouldn't be much longer. It's your choice.
I'll give him another minute.
Okay. Where are my manners? Can I get you anything while you wait?
I'll take something cold if you'll join me.
Good water. Go ahead, drink up.
Is that a working fireplace?
Other than the fact that it doesn't have a damper.
Damper?
The thing that you open when you're burning a fire so the smoke goes out the chimney. And you close it when you're not burning so you don't lose any heat. It also keeps the animals out. Birds and such.
Well, I guess I don't know much about fireplaces. They're pretty, though.
I like the flames. They remind me of a bunch of tongues licking at the wood.
So, do you live here with Alex?
No. How's that water?
Good. How's yours?
So how'd you meet Alex?
On the internet.
On the internet? You have to be careful with that kind of stuff. There's a lot of nuts out there over those computers.
I'm not worried. Alex seems like a perfect gentleman.
Let me get this straight. You meet some guy over the computer, and then you come to his house? And you said this was a blind date, so you don't even know what he looks like.
That's right.
Not so smart, if you ask me.
For our first in-person meeting, we decided to meet for coffee. In public, in the morning. Wouldn't you say that's pretty safe? Only Alex said his car was in the shop, so he gave me his address, had me to drive by and honk, and he said he'd be right out. Sounded pretty safe to me. Are you sure you're not Alex?
What?
Well, you wouldn't be just pretending to not be Alex because maybe I wasn't what you were expecting.
No, I wouldn't.
If you want to call this whole thing off, that's fine. Just tell me and I'll leave. But don't leave me on and don't play games.
I said I'm not Alex.
Okay. Have you known Alex long?
I'm helping him do some work around the place.
Oh, is that what you do for a living? A handyman, I mean?
No!
Well, what do you do?
I'm over at the Madisonville Psychiatric Hospital.
The insane asylum?
It's a facility for the mentally disturbed.
Well, but you know all about the escape, then.
The escape?
Yeah, I was on the radio today, a couple days ago, where their patients escaped. They say he's really dangerous. Well, but you've probably heard about it.
What, you think I didn't hear about it?
Well, what happened?
I don't know!
Sorry, I just thought it. Well, yeah, you know what? It's really scary, but I think I saw him.
Who?
The escaped lunatic. I think I saw him this morning on my way here. He was standing outside my car just staring at me. Oh, it gives me the creep just thinking about it.
It wasn't him.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do you know?
You see, you report this shit to the media and suddenly everywhere people turn, they see a maniac on the loose. So what do you think this guy's just gonna walk around in broad daylight and show everyone how crazy he is? He's too smart for it.
So, do you know who it is?
What? No! Look, what the hell's with all the questions here? Or I wasn't there when it happened, okay? I don't know anything about it. What, am I supposed to have all the answers? Am I? Am I?
We will return to Maniac on the Loose after these messages.
We now return to Maniac on the Loose.
Are you okay there?
Help you, sir?
Do you live here?
Why, yes. Yes, I do.
For how long?
Well, not long. Why do you ask?
I spent some of my childhood in this house.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I used to live here.
Well, is that so? How long has it been since you moved out?
It's been a while.
Well, the reason I'm asking is because I know quite a bit about the history of this house. A number of different families have lived here over the years. Did you live here long?
Long enough. I'm in from out of town. This is the first time I've been back in over 20 years.
20 years? Well, that's quite a hiatus. Are you back in town for a reason?
My father's funeral.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to pry.
It's all right. I didn't really know him. We had a strained relationship.
I am so, so sorry to hear that. That is a true tragedy. A father and son having a difficult relationship.
I guess I'm looking for some closure, and they brought me here.
Well, what can I do to help?
Would it be asking too much if I could see my old room?
Well,
That's all right. Like, you don't know me. I shouldn't be putting you in an awkward position like this.
No. Come on in.
Are you sure it's okay?
Absolutely. Forgive me if I seem overly interested in your predicament, but I can relate to you. You see, I too had a difficult relationship with my own father, though I was able to rectify the situation. I'm sorry that you weren't able to come up with a similar solution during your own father's lifetime, but perhaps revisiting a few old ghosts would be just what the doctor ordered for you.
Maybe.
You know, family is really all we have in this life. It's the only thing that you can truly depend on. One should never be without family. That's my motto.
Is that so?
Which room was yours?
Upstairs.
I have a theory about family. What do most people think of when they think of family? Blood relatives, right? But what about the spouse? The spouse isn't a blood relative, yet typically he or she is considered to be the most important member of a family. This is the basis of my theory. Does a family member have to be a blood relative? I don't think so. A family member can be anyone. So theoretically, a person can pick and choose who one's family is.
Interesting theory.
Oh, here I am rambling on and on. I've got to be getting ready soon. Believe it or not, I've got a date this morning.
A date? This early?
Well, it's our first date, and I wanted the young lady to feel as safe and secure as possible.
Well, what's the lucky girl's name?
Melissa. Isn't it beautiful?
Sure.
You know, we seem to have a lot in common, but more importantly, we seem to share the same morals and values. They're so important when two people are thinking of starting a family together. And I don't want to be getting ahead of myself here, but she might be the one.
How fortunate for you.
Oh, I'm sorry. Here I am going on and on about my hopes and dreams, and here you are just trying to get some closure over the strained relationship you had with your father.
It's okay.
Did your troubles with your father start in this house?
In this room, to be exact. This room is my prison.
Well, it's not anymore.
No, it's not.
You've taken the first step. I'm sorry. You know, I never even asked you your name.
No. You didn't.
I think it's admirable. Heartwarming, really. That you care enough to come back here on the day of your father's funeral and try to make amends. And to come back here to the house where I'm sure you spent most of your time together and you lived with each other. I mean, that's love. That's what that is. Good old-fashioned love.
Love, respect, amends.
I don't think you understand, Alex. I hate my father
with a passion.
The only reason I came to town today was so after that son of a bitch was in the ground, I could spit on his grave.
Now you can't mean that.
Oh yes, I do.
No, no, you can't be talking about your father in that manner. Father and son's love is vital. He's your father. He's your family.
Yes. Yes, he is. I'll give you that. He's my family whether I like it or not because he's my own flesh and blood. You see, unlike your bullshit theory, that's the only kind of real family there is. Flesh and blood. That's it.
No, 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 no. You're wrong. What about a spouse? A wife? I mean, a wife isn't true flesh and blood, but she's just as much a family member as anyone else.
A wife? Let me tell you what a wife is. Let me tell you about that for a second. A wife is nothing more than an object that you breed with to produce your own true flesh and blood.
No, no, you're wrong, sir, and you're wrong to speak about your father that way.
Okay.
I mean, I don't care what happened between the two of you, but you cannot speak about your father in that way in my house. How dare you, sir? How dare you?
We will return to Maniac on the Loose after this message. And now back to Maniac on the Loose.
Izzy!
least I'm trying not to be. I thought you quit smoking.
I did, and then my husband left me.
Left you?
Yeah, 2 days ago. He called me and he said for me to have dinner on the table when he got home where I could find myself and his husband. I told him to shove it, and I haven't seen him since.
Rather extreme. Did you by any chance listen to the voicemail I sent you concerning the patient in room 4113, John Bromley?
That he's to be kept in total isolation until you say otherwise. Yes, I know.
He's to have contact with no one else. I don't want anyone going near that room. You understand me? You make
absolutely
sure of that?
Absolutely.
Now, no one is going to move. It is very dangerous.
I got it. No problem.
Good. Why is it that I always leave Dr. Clark in charge when I go away instead of you? Mm-hmm. I mean, you follow orders so much better than he does.
I had no idea, Dr. Grin.
Between you and me, Dr. Clark is going to be spending a lot more time at the Dawson Springs facility, which means you'll have many more opportunities to start running the show here.
Oh, that'd be terrific, Dr. Grimm. Franklin, do you need me to do anything else?
No, okay. Have you seen the head of security?
You mean ski mask?
Yes, ski mask.
Well, isn't he on vacation?
Yes, but have you seen him, though?
No, and personally, I wouldn't care if he went on a permanent vacation.
Enjoy your cigarette.
We used to date. Long time ago.
You mark my words. One more sexual harassment suit against you and you're out on your buttocks, do you understand me?
Yes, sir. It'll never happen again.
Good.
Listen, what? Well, I've got you here.
What?
I have to discuss a patient with you.
Oh, for crying out loud, would you fix your tie?
And there go the lights again. Maybe you ought to have maintenance look into that.
What would we do without you?
Yeah, I just want to ask you something. It's about the patient in 4102.
Bradley Keith?
Yes. Yeah, that's really impressive. How about that?
Yes, Doctor, continue.
Yes, well, anyway, Dr. Graham, for some reason, he keeps going on and on about Marty Feldman. It's Marty Feldman this, Marty Feldman that. I just can't seem to get his mind off of Marty Feldman. You know Marty Feldman? The actor?
Yes, I know who Marty Feldman is, the actor.
I just thought maybe you hadn't seen Young Frankenstein. And
yes, I've seen Young Frankenstein, and I've seen the Marty Feldman show, and I've seen Silent Movie and Yellowbeard and In God We Trust, and I've even seen The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes' Smarter Brother.
Well, I'm sorry.
Have you read the patient summary? If you had, you wouldn't be wasting my time and yours with all these questions. The patient is suffering from an acute case of dissociative fugue. He thinks he's Gene Wilder. Today he's fixated on Marty Feldman, tomorrow it'll be Madeline Kahn, the day after that it'll be Richard Pryor, and he'll even be fixated on Mel Brooks.
Gene Wilder? Really?
Yes. Gene Wilder, the actor.
Yes, I know who Gene Wilder is.
Oh, thank God. I was beginning to think that you hadn't seen Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
I have seen Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
Not the remake?
No. Gene Wilder, Jack Albertson.
Good.
Yeah.
Perhaps you should think of giving up psychiatric medicine.
Hospital officials have yet to confirm the escape of one of their mental patients, who is described by our anonymous source as extremely dangerous. We've been trying all morning to get confirmation. Dr. Franklin Grimm, head of the hospital for the past decade, will not take our call.
How long?
His secretary claims Dr. Grimm is
I don't
not
know.
How long has this been out since this morning?
Been spotted in the parking lot.
Surely,
this point,
you know something about the report. You know, get the hell out of here!
2 days ago, and is described as extremely dangerous. The current Madisonville Psychiatric Hospital patient uniforms are green stuff with the letters APA and the patient number is just below the left.
Happy little couple. Don't you think he's a little old for you?
I'm not that old.
Shut up! I asked you a question! When I ask you a question, I expect an answer. Now, don't you think he's a little old for you?
No, he's not too old!
Oh, really? Sure looks a lot older than you.
I'm not that old.
Shut up! You shut up! You don't say anything unless I tell you to. You keep that trap shut unless I ask you something directly.
Just calm down.
What the hell did I just say to you? All right. You're not going to listen to me? Let me explain it to you in terms you'll understand. No, Ski Mask wouldn't have believed that he enjoys this kind of thing way too much.
Who then?
I don't know. It wasn't me. Why don't you take the rest of the day off?
Are you sure?
Oh.
Is there anything I can do to help?
No. If you're not here, then there's no one to answer the phone, okay?
Oh, okay, Dr. Grant.
Go on in and go on home and
Thank you. Thank you so much. Now, I want you to see everything. That requires a simple answer. I'm gonna ask you one more time. You better give me a yes or no, or I am gonna hack your head clean off. Sexually, are you pure?
No!
No! Oh, well, there's a shock! Hey, look at that little slut box. I bet you like it, don't you? I bet you like it hard. Do you want to die? Do you? Because I want to kill you. I want to kill you so bad. Come on, just give me a reason. Give me no choice. Now tell me you didn't like that. You filthy little whore!
I bet a lot of different guys have been inside here, haven't they? Yeah. Yeah, how easy is it to become a member of this club, huh? Come on, how many? How many different guys have been inside here? Come on, tell me. How many? How many different guys have been inside
Please
here?
Just let me go!
Come on, tell me, how many? Answer me! How many? How many?
Okay, three!
What? Three? Is that what you said, three?
Yes, three, I swear!
I was talking about your entire life, not just last night!
Three, I promise! I was married twice! Had a boyfriend, I was engaged in between them, I swear!
That is the biggest crock of shit I've ever heard in my life! Three! You believe this bullshit, three?
I believe everything this young lady's saying!
Yeah, you would, idiot!
Please, do we want the same thing, we swear!
Shut up, tramp! Yeah, that's what you are, isn't it? A tramp. Yeah, I bet you have a little tramp stamp, don't you?
No, I don't know what you're
talking about. Don't you? Answer me, do you?
I don't know what you're talking about!
You know, a tramp stamp. The stamp of a tramp.
I don't know what you're talking
about. Oh, come on! It's a tattoo that skanky little whores put right above their ass so the world can see what a dirty little tramp they are! A tramp stamp. Yeah. You have one, don't you? Don't you?
Please, no!
All right, well, let's just find out. I knew it! You filthy little lion whore! Three, my ass!
I'm not lying, I swear!
Yeah. Leave her alone, she said she wasn't lying! Well, well, well. Listen to Prince Charming here coming to the rescue. Man, you must need to get laid real bad if you are risking your life to impress this little skank!
I'm not trying to impress anyone! Enough is enough!
Please!
Just leave her alone, you hear me?
What did you say to me?
I said leave her alone.
You want to suffer?
Look, she didn't do anything to you. She just came here to go on a date with me. Just leave her alone! She doesn't deserve this!
Okay, Mr. Please. Tough Guy. You wanted to find me, go right ahead. But you just cost this little floozy a finger!
No! No, 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 stop! No, no, no!
Please, no! No,
no!
No,
no!
No,
no, stop, stop! I won't say anything more, I promise!
Please, no! Please!
No, 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 I mean it! I won't say anything more, I promise!
No!
Don't!
No!
No, please, please, please don't!
No!
No, listen, listen, listen!
Let go.
Oh, no!
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 No,
no! No.
No!
No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! No! no, no.
Shut up!
Okay, okay.
She looks good. What? I want some of that.
No.
And what I want, I get.
Please don't. No. 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 Stop. Don't.
No.
Don't.
No, please let us go.
Just leave her alone. Let us go. Stop it.
Dawson Springs.
Such a lovely family you had. Such a lovely wife. I hear she remarried.
I heard the same thing.
Was it worth it, Franklin? Choosing this job over your wife and daughter?
What do you want, Gordon?
An escaped mental patient. It sounds so sinister. And the reports all over the news. You must be at wit's end.
No, I'm fine.
Well, look at the bright side.
The bright side?
They don't know who the escaped mental patient is. Apparently nobody does. We're all going to find out sooner or later, you know. My money's on sooner.
Thank you so much for your concern, Dr. Clark. But I have everything under control.
Oh, do you now?
Yes.
It doesn't seem like it. The escape took place how long ago? 2 days? And you still haven't made a formal announcement. What are you waiting on, Dr. Graham? What's the delay? Wait. I get it. You sent that psychopath ski mask out to catch him, didn't you? You want to cover this whole thing up. You expect ski mask to apprehend him and bring him back, and then you can say that the entire thing was a huge misunderstanding. Has Ski Mask caught him yet? Apparently not. It's been 2 days. Not working out quite the way you planned, is it, Dr. Grimm? You send a psychopath to catch a psychopath.
What do you expect to happen?
Ski Mask will do his job.
So it is true.
Nothing is true. I didn't say that.
You expect Ski Mask to pull off this assignment?
Expect anything. He is
as crazy as any patient that we have housed in this facility.
He's the best head of security I have ever known.
By far.
By far!
He is deranged. The man wears a ski mask, for God's sake. No one's ever seen him without it on, except for you. Hell, I don't even know his real name.
Do you want to know his real name, Gordon? Is that it? Do you want to know his name? If you want to know his name, why don't you just go right up to him and rip that mask off his face and look in his psychopathic eyes and demand to know his name? Why don't you do that? Because you're afraid of him, that's why. He hides his identity to protect himself from patients who might hold a grudge.
And why would patients hold a grudge? It wouldn't be because of the abuse that he puts them through, would it? Do you know how many patients have filed complaints with me against his brutality?
I'm through talking about Ski Mask. I'm through talking about everything altogether. Now, for the last time, get out of my office.
But you haven't given me a chance to answer your question.
What question?
Earlier, you asked me what I wanted.
Okay.
I want your resignation.
Who the hell are you to ask me for my resignation? That's it. We're done.
We haven't finished our discussion.
Yes, we have. I don't need a shark circling me in my own building when I have plenty of them outside. Gordon, you're fired.
Oh, you think the sharks are circling now? Imagine the feeding frenzy when they find out that the escaped mental patient is none other than the infamous serial killer, John Bromley.
How do you know it's John Bromley?
Because if word got out that John Bromley escaped while you were in charge, it would likely cost you your job.
Who told you the identity of the escaped patient?
It's been 2 days, Dr. Grimm.
I think it's a safe bet that Bromley is probably killed already. In fact, I would say it's a sure thing.
You son of a bitch.
You son of a bitch. It was you. You let him out. I knew it. I knew it. I knew it had to be an inside job. Ski Mask would never have allowed something like this to happen.
Well, fortunately, Ski Mask can't be here 24 hours a day. You know, it's kind of funny how quiet things are around here before the first shift arrives.
You are deliberately trying to ruin me.
Yes, I am.
I brought you up in the ranks. You are in the position you're in because of me. You're a shoo-in to take over when I retire.
And when will that be, Dr. Grimm? 5 years, 10 years, 20, ever? I am not going to spend the rest of my life waiting for you to retire. It's time for a change, Dr. Grimm. It's my time.
Gordon, I think we should work something out here. I'll give you anything you want.
I want your job.
Gordon, anything but that.
Sorry, Dr. Grimm. You resign immediately on your terms, or I'll let them in on who it is that's running around out there, and I'll tell them about your desire to cover the whole thing up. And then I'll stand back and watch them lynch you.
I will tell them that you are behind the whole thing.
Prove it.
This job means everything to me.
What are you doing?
Some choose a common path. Some choose a path less traveled. And some choose a path unknown.
Do you believe in vampires?
We now return to Maniac on the Loose.
She must have gone into shock and died. She's still warm, though. What the hell was that?
I don't know.
Is there somebody else in this house?
No!
I'm gonna go look.
If I find somebody else in this house, I'm gonna cut them like a fish! And then I'm gonna come back here, and I'm gonna decorate this room with your intestines!
Thank you.
do anything right.
Bite your tongue and listen to me. I'll be home when I'm home. Come on. I'm the head of this family.
John, I'm head of this family.
I'm giving the orders here.
I'm giving the orders here.
You better have dinner on the table when I walk through that door, or you can find yourself a new husband.
What can I do for you?
How long have you lived here, sir?
About 10 years.
10 years? That's a long time to live in one place. You agree?
Not really. The house I had before this was my home for 20 years.
And what caused you to move from there?
A job.
Do you live here with your family?
No, I'm divorced. Excuse me, I don't mean to be rude, but are you conducting an interview here?
I don't believe in divorce myself.
I sure wish my ex-wife's attorney felt that way.
Oh, once you're married, there's no way out. Except death, of course. God forbid. Ah, family. That's what it's all about.
Let me try this one more time. Who are you and what exactly do you want?
You'll have to forgive me. I used to live here when I was younger. It's my home. It'll always be my home. I must say, I do admire the decor. I expect the inside's just as nice.
I'd like to think so.
Did you decorate it yourself?
Oh, no. My ex-wife did all of this before she left. I decided to keep it, though. The women really love it. In fact, I've come to think of this as my own private beaver trap. So, you used to live here?
Yes, when I was younger.
I'm a bit of a historian. I've kept records on all the families that have lived here before.
Ah.
The Bromleys used to live here.
The Bromleys?
You know, John Bromley?
The name sounds familiar.
John Bromley, the serial killer. He used to live here with his parents and 3 siblings. About 2 weeks after they moved out, he chopped them up to bits. Apparently, he wasn't too thrilled with his father's decision to relocate the family. And after he eluded the authorities, evidently, he got married, if you can believe that.
John, what are you doing? John!
He even wound up having a daughter.
What are you doing now?
He was a textbook husband and father until he decided to chop them up to pieces, too. Apparently, they weren't the perfect family that he was hoping for.
Past never did interest me much. I'm more of a future man. You can't live the past, you know.
Oh, I don't live in the past. I just find it interesting.
I don't. It's all about the future. And right now.
Other than myself and the Bromleys, there have been only 3 other families that have lived here, and judging by your age, I can't tell that you fit the description of any of them.
Is that so?
What's your last name?
Bromley.
Oh, that's a good one. So, Bromley, are you related to John?
I'm pausing because I'm not quite sure how to answer that question.
Why is that?
Get away from me! No!
Thank you.
I've really enjoyed getting to know you today, Melissa. You feel the same?
Alex, hurry, he's gonna come back soon.
I felt an immediate connection. I feel as if we have the same morals and values. I think together we can create the perfect family.
Alex!
Do you want that? Do you want that too? Do you want the perfect family?
Alex, come on, let's go!
We can do it, we can do it, we can do it together as man and wife.
I don't know what you're talking about, come on!
Will you marry me, Melissa?
Alex, come on, let's go!
Will you marry me, will you?
No, come on, I don't know what you're talking about.
This is your last chance, Melissa. I can't let anyone else have you.
Please, come on and tie me!
I'm sorry it has to be this way, Melissa.
It could have been perfect.
We will return to Maniac on the Loose after these messages.
Franklin, I know you're in there. I heard your voice just a second ago.
Just a minute, I'll be there.
Franklin, open the door. Franklin, what are you doing in there? Franklin, let me in. Franklin, open the door. Franklin?
Hello, Kate. How are you?
Franklin, what's going on? You're acting strange.
Nothing is going on. Everything's fine.
Do you have a girl in there?
No.
It's that bimbo from accounting, isn't
what?
It? That bleached blonde from accounting.
Who?
Oh, Miss Silicon Valley. I see you checking out her fake boobs.
No one's in there, Kate. Except me. I'll tell you what. Let's go somewhere. Let's go get some coffee, okay?
Franklin, where's your tie?
I'm not wearing it. Come on, let's go.
Franklin, you're acting strange.
No, come here, Kate. No, no! It's Dr. Clark.
Well, is he dead?
He fell. He fell and hit his head. I did everything I could, but...
Call a nurse. Get a cart in here. I don't see any signs of head trauma.
Oh, my God.
Hello?
Ski mask. Oh, thank God I finally got a hold of you.
What do you want? I'm busy.
Did you find Bromley?
Yeah.
You did? Is he there? What happened?
Will you settle down?
Is he secured?
Yes.
Oh, finally, something's right there. Did you have any problems?
Piece of cake.
Where did you find him?
He came back to his old house.
You're kidding. You were right.
Of course I was right. I know him. I've been guarding this maniac for over 2 years. I know what makes him tick.
Well, how did you get into the house?
He invited me.
Well, how did you manage that?
Haven't you been listening? I know him. I know his tendencies. All I had to do was talk about family, so I made up some bullshit about having a strained relationship with my father, and that was that.
He actually went back to the house. Amazing. I thought he was smarter than that.
Smart has nothing to do with it. He's obsessed with things being perfect. To him, this is the perfect house. There was no way he could keep from coming back. He wants to live in the perfect house with the perfect family. That's what drives his insanity. It overcomes his intelligence.
Did you kill him?
Not yet. I think it'll be best if we just sedate him, bring him back to the hospital, and I'll hang him in his room and make it look like suicide. Then you can come up with some creative bullshit as to why you didn't tell the cops. I'm sure you'll think of something plausible.
I know just how to handle it.
Oh, by the way, I'm going to have an innocent bystander casualty.
That?
Who? Just some slut. She saw me. I can't let her live. It's nothing for you to worry about.
I see. On a related note, I have a problem here that will need your help.
What?
Well,
spit it out, man!
I have a couple of casualties here myself.
What do you mean?
You know Dr. Clark and Dr. Lewis?
Yeah.
Well, they're kind of, well, in a word, they're dead.
What? What happened?
They knew too much. They saw too much.
They just... Are you trying to tell me that you killed them?
Well, I'd rather not put it in those terms, but that they just had too much information.
And settle down. I'll take care of it.
Hold it. Are you there, Ski Mask? Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Listen, get over here as soon as you can and help me with these guys first, and then we'll clean up your mess.
Over there?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Sure. Sure.
I gotta go.
Now back to Maniac on the Loose.